All right, so you just got your first piano. First of all, congratulations. This is a very exciting step toward your musical future. I tell people all the time that the piano is a perfect place to start for your musical journey. Any instrument that you want to learn after the piano will benefit from your work on the piano. So I'm going to work with you a little bit today and show you some basics of the piano. I'm even going to teach you a couple of chords so you can play songs from Billy Joel, or Billie Eilish, or Bach or Beethoven. The world is your oyster, and I'm going to get you started today. All right, now we're going to move on to the fun part. I am sitting with a Casio keyboard that has 88 keys. Now, your keyboard might have 61 keys, it might be a little bit shorter, but that is a-okay if it looks a little different. The part that we're playing in, you will also have, so you will be ready to rock and roll. As you probably already knew, and as you can see here, our piano is made up of white keys and black keys. And these keys are in a pattern. So we have our two black keys and our three black keys. And again, we go to our two black keys and our three black keys, our two black keys and our three black keys. And the way that this works is as we move up the piano to the right, we're gonna get higher. So if I play the same note and keep going up to the right, I'm getting higher, even though it is the same note. And then if I go down to my left, we're gonna get lower until we're extraordinarily low. Awesome. So when it comes to music, we use seven note names. And those note names, crazy enough, you already know if you are familiar with your alphabet. So we have A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. And those notes are found in this pattern. So I'm going to give you a quick little silly way of figuring out what notes are on what keys on your piano. If you have ever eaten an Oreo or know what an Oreo is, this is going to be a helpful way to find the D key on your keyboard. So what I want you to do is in your pattern of two and three black keys, you're going to find just the two black keys. Just like you have two black cookies on your Oreo, we're going to look for your two black keys. So those are your cookies. So go ahead and touch your keyboard and find those two black keys. Now, we all know that the white cream in the middle of the Oreo is the most delicious part of the Oreo. So if you find your two black keys, you're gonna look for the cream in the middle, which is delicious. And that is your D key. So you can look for all of the Oreos on your keyboard and try and find the D's. So I'm gonna find my two black cookies. I'm gonna find delicious. And then keep moving up your piano. Find your two black keys. Delicious. That's your D. Two black keys. Delicious. And so on and so forth. So that will always be your D key. And what you can do when it comes to the piano is you can use the alphabet that you know and little tricks like that to find where your keys go. So if I know each time that this is my D, I can use what I know of my alphabet to say, okay, what comes after D? A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. So you're already learning what these key names are. And then, because it is a pattern and because we're only using those first seven letters of the alphabet, we're going to start back over with A after our G. So I'm going to do A, B, C, and look where we are again. That cream in the middle is delicious. So use your alphabet. You can pause this video and watch that as many times as you need to and start figuring out what those key names are. So now that we know how to find what our keys are and what their names are, I'm going to teach you a little bit of the technique on how to hold your hands. Now, I know that sounds silly. We all know how to hold our hands. But if you will take a look at your fingers, hold them up like this, you can see that all of my fingers are different heights. Nobody's, well, somebody's fingers might all be the same height. My fingers are not the same height. So if I'm putting them on the piano like this, my little pinkies and my little thumbs cannot play those notes. So what I want you to do is I want you to hold your palms up like this, and I want you to pretend that you're very delicately holding a bubble and you're trying really hard not to pop it. So your hands are going to be a little bit rounded, And you'll notice that when I'm doing that, suddenly all of my fingertips are just about the same height. And what this will do when you flip it over and you're ready to play is it will put all of your fingertips at the same height so that you can really move and play the keys really organically and very smoothly. So if I've got my bubble, I want to flip it over, nice and gentle, and then I'm ready to put my fingers on my keyboard. So in piano, to help us out, we have numbered our fingers. So I want you to put your hands up like this, and when you're giving someone a thumbs up, it's kind of a way to say, like, you're number one. That's how I always remember that my pointer finger isn't number one. Our thumb in piano is our number one finger. So hold up your thumbs. That's our number one. So therefore, number two is our pointer finger. So wiggle those number twos, all right? Number three is our middle finger. Number four is our ring finger. And then number five are those pinkies. So let's wiggle our number ones, wiggle those number twos, our number threes, number fours, and number fives. So a lot of times when we're working through a book or working through a song, they will have little numbers above some of our notes to help us out when we're learning how to read sheet music, which will come in the future. And it will tell you where they want your fingers to be located. So it's important for us to learn those finger numbers to help us out along the way. So I am now going to teach you four different chords to play on the piano. And then we're going to use those four chords to play the song Let It Be by the Beatles. So when we are playing these chords, we're going to utilize our finger number one, right? Our thumb, because you're number one. Our finger number three. And our pinkies, our finger number five. Those are the only ones that are going to be playing. So practice that, just using those three fingers. It's gonna feel weird at first. These two fingers are gonna feel a little funky sticking up in the air, but you will get more used to it as you play. And remember to keep that hand nice and rounded as you play. So what we're going to do is we are going to put our thumb, so our finger number one, on what we call middle C. So I'm gonna hold that down. Find middle C on your piano. It's right next to our cream in the middle is delicious, right? So we're gonna go on our C. Our pointer finger, finger number two, is gonna go on our D. Middle finger will be on our E. I'm using that alphabet. On our F, pinky is on our G. Now, like I said, we're only gonna use one, three, and five. And that makes up something called a chord. So we're using our C, our E, and our G. And when we play it all at the same time, so push them all at the same time like this, it makes a gorgeous chord for us to play and sing along with. So practice that a few times. Feel free to pause it. Practice that C chord. It's only those white keys, C, E, G, with our one finger, our three finger, and our five finger. Now we are going to move along to our G chord. So we're doing a little bit of a jump. So I want you to take your hand and we're gonna use that thumb to find our G. So I'm gonna walk through it with you. If I've got my C, D, E, F, and G, that's where our thumb is gonna be for this chord. So go ahead and bring the rest of your fingers up here. So we've got our G, A, B, C, and D. And remember, we're only using our thumb, middle, and pinky. So again, we're making a gorgeous chord. Let's push them all down together. And that is our G chord. So take a minute, practice that G chord. You can even go back, and I encourage that you do, to practice going from our C chord and moving all the way up. And actually, your thumb is gonna go right where that pinky is. You're just gonna shift up, keeping those three fingers. You're gonna lock right into that next chord. Awesome, so we've got our C and our G. Now, this is some pretty advanced stuff, so Don't get frustrated. Take your time. Practice it as many times as you can and as you want to. You can always rewind it, but I'm sure you're doing an awesome job. So we've got two of our chords down. The next one that we're going to work on is called an A minor. So we were just on our G. And what happens when we get to the end of our alphabet that we use in music? We start again. So if we were just on our G and we use A, B, C, D, E, F, G, we're starting right over on our A. So what you're gonna do is take that thumb, boop, shift it right up. So you're just moving all of your fingers up one key, scooching it like that. And I'm using my thumb, my middle finger, and my fourth pinky. So that is called an A minor. So practice that A minor with me a couple times. Good. So let's put those three together that we've learned so far. I'm going back to my C. Scooching where my pinky is. My thumb is traveling up. Using those three fingers only. That's my G. Then I'm going to A minor. We're shifting everything up just one white key. Nice. Do that a couple times. We got our C and our G, and we're scooching just up one to our A minor. Very nice. Practice that a couple times. Now, the last one that we're going to work on together today is an F. So we're traveling back down a little bit. So we've just been at our A minor. Now, again, when we have our chord, that thumb is on whatever that chord name is. That's where we're finding our notes. If we have a C chord, that thumb's on C. G chord, our thumb is on G. A minor, that thumb is on A. So where do you think your thumb might be if you're doing an F? Correct, it is on the F. So we're traveling from our A minor. Our thumb is gonna find our F. So again, find your D if you need help. D-licious, E, and F. I'm gonna pop that thumb on my F. Every finger gets a key. And what three fingers do I use for my chords? I use my one, my three, and my five. So there's your F. Very nice. Play that again for me. Good. So our whole lineup of our chords, and again, take some time to practice. Practice moving around. You can watch this video as many times as you need to. I'm going from my C. Next is our G. Look where you're going. Finding that G with your eyes. Moving on up. We're moving up one set of white keys to our A minor. Whoop. And then we're shifting back down, finding that F. Going all the way back down. Thumb is on F. Good. So, all together, I'm going to go just a touch faster. We're going from my C to my G, A minor, down to my F. Let's do it again. C up to G, A minor to the F. All right, how'd you do? Excellent. So now that we have those four chords, we are going to use them to play the song Let It Be by the Beatles. So please play along with me, and if you know the song, feel free to sing along as well. All right, starting with our C, ready, and C, and G, and A minor, and F, C, and G, now we're going to F, and C. C and G and A minor and F and C and G to the F, F and C. Amazing job.
Thank you so much for playing along with me today, and thank you so much for shopping at Spicer's Music. We value our customers so much, and you are what makes us special. If you liked what you saw, we would be thrilled to have you in our lessons program. We have phenomenal instructors who are so fun and encouraging and would love to connect with you. Please give us a call or come in the store, and I would be happy to get you started.